Hi, I'm Alana with the Coding Clubhouse, here with
Eric Manchin.
So you do RealSense, right?
I do. I'm working with developers to help educate them about how to leverage RealSense into their products.
So for those of us who haven't seen our last RealSense video, what do you guys do?
So what RealSense brings to the table is obviously there's been a lot of cameras out there for a long time, but it actually adds a 3D scanning ability using IR. And so when you ever use it in, whether it's even a PC application or like robotics, it can not only see like our eyes see, but it can see like our eyes can in terms of being able to tell depth, and that's important.
So how can this application be used?
So that's the interesting part, right? It's not only can it be useful in PC applications, right? There's a number of companies like Razer and Creative that are making peripheral cameras that'll sit on top for fun things, but in the world of robotics, it's immensely useful because robots are cool until they run into your leg, and then they hurt. And this could make it so that the robot can tell depth and stop before it runs into your leg, which would be better.
So what's the limit to this technology?
So there's a couple of things that are involved. Obviously, whenever you deal with things like any sort of emissions, there are ranges involved and whatnot. So for right now, the RealSense range has a certain parameters. It can't go beyond, say, up to maybe 20 feet. But still, in when you're talking about a robot moving around like an environment like this, it would be immensely useful, right? Because it would be able to tell that things are going from 20 to 18 and so forth, getting closer. So how
have you guys improved your technology since the last time we interviewed you?
Well, so we've had a couple of different cameras that have come out. And one of the things that will be coming out into the future, because we do anticipate, and we've already talked about this in the beginning of the year, is we added what they call an IMU, which is a fancy way of saying basically a bunch of gyroscopes and whatnot, so that the camera can not only tell, see, and then have depth like it had before, but also be able to tell when you're changing orientation. So if the robot turns left, the right, whatever, things like that. And we'll also be adding in a fisheye lens, which helps the algorithms that you'd be doing in that kind of environment.
Cool. So what advice do you have for young coders?
So I have a great job. I'm very fortunate. I get to go around and I meet a bunch of people that are in software development. And the one thing I have found almost universally is when somebody is a software developer, they're almost never lacking for a job. And so I think coding is a great way to get into the tech field. I think the tech field is a very exciting and energizing place to be. So the biggest advice I'd have is don't worry about what you learn to program. Mm-hmm. Almost every software developer I know learned one language and then moves on to others. So start anywhere and get going.
Yeah. So do you have anything else to say?
Yeah, no, it's great to see you guys here. We were able to talk before at AWU. I'm glad you're out there sending the message to the young people to get excited in tech. I think it's an absolute wonderful thing, and I'd like to thank you for doing it.
Cool. So just a second. You talked about your job earlier. What's your title exactly?
So I normally tell people I'm a nerd herder, which is probably the most descriptive and accurate way. Some people call me a technology evangelist, but nerd herder seems to fit better.
Cool. Okay. Well, that's all from me. Bye.
Bye.